Well, today we remember the life and legacy of civil rights icon Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. But as our Mark Thompson explains, Arizona's history with the holiday hasn't been an honorable one.
As we celebrate Martin Luther King Day, I think it's important to take a look back at how much of a struggle it was to get the holiday recognized in the first place here in Arizona, a struggle fitting for the man that the holiday aims to honor.
I have a dream.
At first, it was all good. Governor Bruce Babbitt in May of 1986 signing an executive order to officially recognize Martin Luther King Day in the state of Arizona. The same year, the rest of the nation first celebrated the holiday just a few months before. President Ronald Reagan declaring the national holiday in 1983. But in came Governor Evan Meekum, quickly rescinding the executive order in 1987, depriving the black community and scarring the state with a reputation of intolerance that's taken decades to fade.
It still has. Some people still don't think we have the King holiday. It's amazing how that narrative hasn't changed nationally for us.
Pastor Warren Stewart, Sr. of First Institutional Baptist Church, was the driving force behind the community effort to secure the King holiday. Stewart leading thousands in a march on the state capitol on a cold and rainy would-be King Day in 1988. His son, Warren Jr., remembers the time well.
It was, you know, an overwhelming good energy, and just we all were focused. You know, when you have that many people focused on one thing, it felt like the March on Washington. And I mean, literally, it was the March on Washington in Phoenix down the Washington Avenue. So you know, it was just good to see people fighting for the same thing and a diverse group of people.
But for 6 years, the state resisted, ballot measures failing as stubborn attitudes remained.
There were people out there who felt that, you know, Martin Luther King wasn't worthy of a holiday here in Arizona. And you still have some people who think that way. Just
Clovis Campbell is the publisher of the Arizona Informant, the weekly black newspaper now celebrating its 50th year in the Valley. Campbell says the paper organized the first boycott of the state back then, convincing the National Newspaper Publishers Association to cancel its midwinter convention scheduled for downtown Phoenix in protest of the King holiday decision. Many others were soon to follow.
A lot of the entertainers, you know, Stevie Wonder made it clear that he wanted to boycott Arizona. A lot of the rappers.
Leah Landrum Taylor served 16 consecutive years in the Arizona State Legislature. A grad student at the time, she wrote her master's thesis on the King holiday controversy, speaking with all the key players like State Senators Art Hamilton and Sandra Kennedy. This as the King holiday navigated its way through the murky waters of state politics.
What happened is there were other measures on there. So it looked as if you voted for the MLK holiday, you would then take away, at that time, the Columbus Day holiday. And so there was a lot of the debate that went on about that.
And it took courage to take a stand.
On a personal note, my family and I, we went out and we were a part of the various peaceful marches that took place when we were trying to get the holiday.
The pushback, you know, there were memories, people burned bushes in our house. People found out where my dad lived, we lived. And threatened to kill him, and you know, for fighting for justice. And this is in the late 80s and 90s.
And unfortunately, many say it wasn't a change of hearts that finally tipped the balance. Instead, it was a blow to corporate bank accounts. The NFL stripping Arizona of the Super Bowl and moving it to California.
Some of those real conservative people that didn't want the holiday, all of a sudden they thought it was a pretty good idea to have the holiday because it started hitting them where it hurt the most.
The vote finally passing in 1992.
I have a dream.
Giving Arizonans the celebration they had been fighting for years.
And throughout that celebration, I had something that occurred that I thought would never happen in my lifetime. And that was having a chance to actually meet Rosa Parks, who came down once the holiday had passed, as well as with Stevie Wonder.
A fitting end to a struggle that represents the very man himself, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Justice, I have a dream.
His message still rings true. That's why we call him a prophetic leader, because his words spoken in the 60s still resonate in 2021.
I have a dream.
a long struggle that is now actually a source of pride, as Arizona is now the only state in the entire country to have the Martin Luther King holiday officially declared by a vote from its people. In Phoenix, Mark Thompson, ABC 15, Arizona.